press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi, hello my dear students. Yes, today I am going to start a new chapter is Animals Living and Surviving. Animals Living and Surviving. In this chapter, you will learn about animals without backbones and those with backbones, classification of animals according to what they eat, classification of animals according to where they live, classification of animals according to how they protect themselves, and finally we are going to discuss about endangered and extinct animals. See, endangered and extinct means, see, some animals are all extinct, some animals are endangered. Example, tiger. See, people are going to hunt animals for their animals' meat, for their claws, nails and skin, leather, and some people are going to hunt animals for their prey also. If you not protect endangered animals, see, that animals will be extinct. So that's why we should protect animals. Okay, if you not protect animals, see, that animals will be extinct. So that's why about these all things you will learn in the last topic, that it is endangered and extinct animals. Yes, right. Yes, my dear students, in the last chapter you learned about plants living and surviving, isn't it? Yes. In this chapter you will learn about animals living and surviving. Yes, you know, animals and plants both are living things, isn't it? Yes, right. Animals and plants both are living things. Why? Because life processing activities are going in these two things also. Life processing activities are going in these two things. So that's why both are living things. You know, so life processing activities means, see, animals can grow, animals can move from place to place, animals can breathe, animals need food, animals feel and react, and animals can reproduce. See, these are all the life processing activities are going in these animals. So that's why animals are living things, isn't it? Yes, right. Yes, my dear students, when you see in your surroundings, we can see different types of animals, isn't it? Namma sutta mutta thumba tarada animals ide alva. So in these animals, some are big, some are small, some are tall, some are short, and some are very small animals also, isn't it? And the colors also very different. We can see different types of animals in your surroundings. In these animals, we classify the animals depending upon their size, depending upon their backbone. See, about the backbone also you will learn in this lesson, and a classification of animals depending upon their what they eat also, and depending upon their where they live also, we will classify the animals, and depending upon the how do they protect themselves also, we can classify the animals. See, depending upon all these things, you will classify the animals. Okay, in this classification, first we are going to learn about animals backbone. So now modlendage animals na backbone bagge nortagonda. So depending upon backbone, we classify two main animals. So two eradu tarada classification maartivi. First one is animals with backbone, animals without backbone. So idr bagge navu iga first learn madona. Okay, yes, right. Yes, we classify the animals depending upon their backbones. There are two types of animals backwards. So there we have one of the classifications. So ee classification alli animals classification alli modlindage backbone na tagota idivi. Okay, see animals without a backbone, and second one is animals with a backbone. So about these things you will learn in this class. Okay, yes, animals with a backbone. Backbone andre enu? ಬೆನ್ನು ಮೂಳೆ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ? ಬೆನ್ನು ಮೂಳೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಬೆನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂಳೆ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಸಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರೇಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್? ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್ ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರೇಟ್. See, we class one of the classification of animals depending upon the backbone. So there are two types of animals. Animals without a backbone is called invertebrate. Means kasheruka matte akasheruka anta helthivi kannadadalli. Animals with a backbone is called vertebrate. So kasheruka. Animals without a backbone, invertebrates, akasheruka anta heli pranigalu anta heli naavu karitteve. Okay, see, first we are going to learn about animals without a backbone. So kelavondu animals galige backbone bennu moolene irodilla. So aa animals na bagge naviga first learn madona. Okay, yes, right. Animals without a backbone means invertebrate animal. Okay, see small animals like insects. See, insects are invertebrates. See insects. Insects are all what? Invertebrates. Invertebrates means, see, insects do not have what? Backbone. So that's why we call insects are invertebrate. Okay, so insects examples like worms, mosquito, housefly, leeches, cockroaches, scorpio, spider, jellyfish also is a example for invertebrate. ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್. ಸಿ, ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಈ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಮೇನ್ ಆಗಿ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೇನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ತ್ರೀ ಮೇನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೇನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. Yes, in insects there are three main parts. That one is head, and this one is thorax, and third one is abdomen. See, there are three main parts in insects. See, insects are main parts of the head, thorax and abdomen. See, these are the three main parts in insects. See, normally in head is consist mainly antenna. So, idana navu en helthivi antenna anti. See, this antenna is find out its smell. So, you know, smell na nodutte. And it's a sense organ. It acts like a sense organ also. Okay. See, this one antenna is helps to smell madlike hage savrane enide anta heli tilkonlike ee antenna use agutte. Okay. And the insects have a compound eye also. See, they have a compound eye and it consists what a mouth also. So head alli mouth irutte. So namage hege mouth ide hage head ide. So mouth ide hage ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೇ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಹೆಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸಾರಿ ಹೆಡ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಟೆನ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಐ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಐಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೌತ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಥೊರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಯಾವುದು? ಥೊರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. ಸಿ, ದಿಸ್ ಥೊರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾವ್ ಥ್ರೀ ಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೆಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಥೊರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಥ್ರೀ ಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೆಗ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಥ್ರೀ ಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಲೆಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ನೋ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾವ್ six legs. Insects have, see, normally insects have antenna. See, antenna helps to search. It acts like a sense organ and also it's a smell and it's a taste the food. Okay, yes. And then mouth is always it helps to eat the food. And compound eyes, it helps to see the environment, means see the things. And then is a next is about a thorax. See, thorax, in thorax legs are attaches to the thorax. Okay, not only thorax, and also some insects have wings also. Have you seen? So kelavanda insects ge wings irutte. Some insects do not have wings, some insects have wings. For example, butterfly, mosquito, and then cockroaches also have insect wings. So kelavanda insects ge enate wings irutte, so they can fly. Some insects cannot fly. So ee cockroach jirlenu swalpa durakke harutte, so they have a what, a flea wings. And butterfly also is an insect. See, this butterfly also have what, wings to fly, isn't it? And some insects do not have wings. See, this wings also is attached to this thorax. So wings also ita ee thorax again agirutte attach agirutte. Okay, see, wings are attach to the thorax also. Okay, yes. Next one part is abdomen. So next one is part what? Abdomen. So normally in abdomen they have digestive organs. ಸೀ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಲ್ಲಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಆ ಥರ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಓರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಬ್ಡೋಮನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಅಬ್ಡೋಮನಲ್ಲಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಇನ್ ಅಬ್ಡೋಮನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೌ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. Okay, see, when we see the parts of an insects, so insects na parts northa hodre, so first one part is head and second one middle one part. So it's a middle section. So head first section and second one section is a thorax, it's a middle one, and last one section is abdomen. See, head consists of two compound eyes and antenna. See, antenna helps to smell and sense the things, and then thorax. So legs are attached to this thorax, and there are three pairs of legs. Three pairs of legs means it's a six legs, and some insects have wings. See, that wings is also attached to this thorax. And last one part is abdomen. See, normally abdomen consists of digestive organs. Okay, you know, insects are breathe through their tiny holes is called what? Spiracles. So tiny holes irutadna spiracles anta heli karutteve. So normally we are breathe through their our nose. See, insects do not have nose. See, they do not have any lungs. They are breathe through their small holes. We call that it is a what? Spiracles, isn't it? Yes, right. See, example for animals without backbone are, so examples yavadu anta northa hodre, mosquito, house fly, and then jellyfish, and then leeches. See, these are all the example for animals without backbone. And see, some insects have a hard part. So it's a exoskeleton irutte, so it's a very hard, little bit hard part irutte. So that hard material is called chitin. See what we call that one part. So many insects, so not all insects, insects have a hard outer covered material is called what? Chitin. See, chitin means it's a outer covering hard part. Some insects, so not all insects. Okay, yes. See, this is about animals without backbone. See, almost it's a insects. You know, in your earth, so in our earth, more than 1 million different types of insects today. See, more than 1 million different types of insects on the earth. So 1 million so different types of insects galu nama earth mele ide. Okay, yes, right. Yes, my dear students, today we discussed about what? Classification of animals. So classification of animals depending upon their size and they what they eat, depending upon where do they live, and how do they protect themselves. About all these things we classify the animals. In this classification, first we learned about animals with a backbone or without backbone. See, first we learned about animals without a backbone. We call it as a invertebrate, means akasheruka pranigalu anta heli karitave. Okay, see, normally all insects are invertebrates. Okay, see, you know, insects means hulagalu anta heli karitave. Okay, so it's a very small animal. See, normally insects have six legs, and some insects can fly. See, when we see the part of insects, there are three main parts in insects. So head, thorax, and abdomen. Say head consists of two compound eyes, and they have two antenna. See, this antenna helps to search food, and it's a smell, and it can taste, and it can act as a sense organ also. And in thorax, see, in thorax, three pairs of legs means six legs are attached to this thorax, and also they have some insects can fly, isn't it? See, that wings are attached to this thorax. And next one part is abdomen. See, abdomen have digestive organs. See, this abdomen consists of what? Digestive organs. And some animals, some insects have hard outer covering material is called what? Chitin. Okay, about these things we learn in this class. Yes, in the next class we will learn about animals with backbone. So next class alalli navu animals with backbone means vertebrates bagge navu discussion madona. Okay, yes, thank you my dear students.